Hello everybody, this is Galileosky Video Blog. My name is Andrei. Today, we will tell you how to connect to the vehicle CAN bus with the help of Galileosky tracker with standard OBDII connector. To do that, we will need the tracker, for example, base block light, a laptop, USB cable, and also we will need this OBDII cable. We made it ourselves. From one side it has standard OBDII connector, from other side Galileosky connector. Such cable provides simple connection and is easy for use. Alternatively, you can connect directly to the corresponding CAN bus wires, CAN high and CAN low, or you can use non-contact readers, like CAN crocodile. First thing is to find the OBDII connector inside the vehicle cabin. Depending on the vehicle's model, the location of the connector might be different. It can be underneath the steering column, to the left of it, or even inside the glove box. In our case, we are connecting to a minivan Hyundai H1. Here is the connector. So now we connect the cable, the tracker. Now we need to connect the tracker to a laptop. For that we use USB cable and start the configurator program. In the configurator we go to the settings tab, CAN tab, and choose the option Listen CAN. If in the diagnostics field we see only messages Start Scan and End Scan, the reason might be that the chosen baud rate is different from the CAN bus actual baud rate. Change the baud rate and click the Apply button. After repeating the Listen CAN task, we can see in the diagnostics field messages received via CAN bus, in this case 11-bit identificators messages. Right now, we are using filter type J1979 or OBDII. Now we move to the Troubleshooting tab and select the points CAN and CAN detailed, and we will see what kind of data the tracker is receiving via OBDII. Here, in the Troubleshooting tab, we can see that we are receiving information about engine coolant temperature and the engine speed. Then we move to the Device tab and make sure that these parameters are shown in the CAN field. We investigated how we can access the CAN bus of the vehicle and how we can scan the received data. By received data, we can learn what protocol is used in the vehicle CAN bus. It can be standard J1979 protocol or FMS, which is used more frequently in the freight transport. In this case, the data is decrypted in accordance with used protocol by default, without any troubles. It also can be J1939 protocol. In this case, we should use user filters on the CAN tab. If the protocol isn't standard, you should look up the protocol description in the internet or decrypt the messages experimentally, as you can see in our video instruction about how to define the fuel level in the CAN bus. Third possible way is using Easy Logic tool. That's it for today. Subscribe to our channel so you can always have access to useful information.